bit short. So the clock is stopped at 5 minutes 15 seconds to go. More importantly, we have got a third and a long hit to win here. They seek to convert just inside Gordon's territory at the 37-yard line. There's a snap back to Lopez. He gives it back to Rogers, trying to give Rogers the block. You can hear the roar of approval there for Chris Chamberlain, number 35, on the defending end of that one. And that's actually going to be a loss of about 4 yards. So with Harold, Bill Harold, what we would think would be a punting situation if the ball is inside their territory now, their home 39-yard line. Remember, of course, in six-man football, the 40 is the lead in the strike. So the ball's at the 39, and indeed, they are going into a punting formation. No one back to receive the punt. There's the kick. It's over in, heading towards the left sideline, and it goes well out of bounds. Let's see where they mark it. They're going to mark it at the 25-yard line, so that punt, actually, they're going to mark it at the 47-yard line, so that punt carries 14 yards. And so they score the Longhorns defense, has risen to the occasion, has given the ball back to their offensive unit. Pretty good field position at the 28. You know, Liv, one interesting part about these offenses, they work a lot on different phases. You get the football, look around, a lot of waiting or running here is going on, and really a lot of things happen just because they happen, but I'm just playing that way. So C11 is five more in the backfield. There's a handoff around the right side. 11, he's got some room, breaks out of one tackle at the 35, and falls forward to the 38-yard line. Sort of an inside reverse, and down some nice yardage to 11. Looks like they're going to mark him at about the 37-yard line and pick up with about 10. So Gordon seems to be perhaps getting rid of a few of those jitters. We have one of the ESPN cameramen out on the field right now, and he's motioned to back away from Coach Delvin Campbell. They're trying to focus on the football game. Second and five, so C in the sign formation has Jesus Saw Arena sign towards the backfield. Gets back to sign for him. Has the room, but his ankle tackled at about the 40. Really has to. Real estate down the right sideline. If he could have gotten past one of the Whitfield Panthers, I believe that's number 12, Brandon Rogers, who had a great tackle, could have been a touchdown saving tackle, because we have seen Sizemore move down the sideline very quickly before. An incredible athlete. So we're all year long through Gordon Longhorns, you know. And the Gordon Longhorns do have a lot of weapons, 11 Sizemore property. I'll tell you what, Sizemore is the bread and butter. Third and a long three. There's a handoff, 11 up the middle. He has to move down and go. Wow. 255 pounds now. That's a large man.
I think I just heard some moose calls out there.
I tell you, he can answer the moose. In fact, I think he probably outweighs Gerald Johnson by a few pounds.
He does.
But in any case, he picked up the first down there. He's not explosive. He is quick. We may see some of that as the game goes on. The first down there, the ball goes to the 34-yard line. There's a good back to find for. Trying to find his way around the right side. He's inside the 30 to the 38. And as you say, Gordon methodically moving the football down the field. Not with a lot of flash or a lot of big plays thus far, but they're doing what Coach Nelson Campbell wants them to do. Call it a pickup of about six or seven, and it will bring second, and let's call it nine.